definitely not a surprise. Okay, cool. So we are recording.
Yay!
Man, Skype's fun. Isn't it fun? It's fun.
So much fun.
What's up, everyone? I am Eakin J.
I'm Emily.
And it is, what is it? It's 10/11/2017, so it's October.
Yes.
Yay! Oh, it's been a little while since we recorded. A lot has been happening.
Yeah. Well, a lot for you.
Yeah. So, well, I'll go ahead and start then.
Yes, you go first. I want to hear all about Disney World.
Yeah. I think I posted photos on the monument tracker. I posted them somewhere. So, So Florida. I flew out to Walt Disney World to celebrate my 47th birthday, because that's what you do when you're 47 years old. You go to a theme park in another state.
That's what you can do any
time. I know. And I need to do so more. So this year, I'll explain the anxiety portion and why this was important for me in a moment. But yeah, I flew out to Florida a few days after Hurricane Irma. Thankfully, first of all, I have a friend who owns a home over in Tampa, which is not that far from, what's the name of the town? Orlando. But specifically the town that Disneyland is, I can't think of the name. But anyway, his house was fine. So, and I actually had emailed back and forth with him going, you know, I feel a little weird going to an amusement park after a hurricane just tore through there. And he's like, dude, mm-hmm. don't worry about it. People need to work. They got jobs, you know.
Exactly,
they're gonna open
yeah.
up. So I'm like, oh, yeah, that's okay. So
I remember seeing an article that, like, someone – they had tickets, and then, like, 9/11 happened, and then they were like, do we still go to Disney World? And it was like, yes, we go, and we enjoy, and, like,
yeah,
it was a little different, but, yeah, still the case of people, everyone that works there wants to be able to work and go back to normal,
yeah.
So.
And in that area, there didn't appear to be that much problem. It's really down towards the Horn where I think most of the damage happened, and of course Cuba and you know, the islands and all that. So I think Florida kind of dodged a bullet big time on that one. Sorry, I just noticed the level was shooting way high. So okay. So, yeah, my flight was long. I brought way too much equipment with me. I brought 3 cameras, 2 cell phones, a laptop, old Samsung tab computer, and just Samsung, sorry, tablet computer, and just, yeah. Mm-hmm. So, a lot of weight. I got there on Thursday night. I was going to go to Epcot because, you know, as you do, because mostly because they had a lot of, they have all the different restaurants, all the different countries mm-hmm. and everything.
Yes.
Soon as I flew in, soon as we landed, got out off the plane, was walking through the airport, and it's like, wow. You know, you hear the expression, not the heat, the humidity.
Mm-hmm.
That's not a joke. I've never experienced anything like that. And I've been to the South where there's apparently a lot of humidity, but nothing like this.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's definitely, and all the people, like yeah. having to get on, like being corralled around and
yeah.
getting on the different trams to the
different portions of the airport. Yeah. And yeah.
yeah.
So I called I got an Uber. And as soon as we start driving to the resort, it starts pouring rain and lightning and thunder.
Ooh.
It was beautiful, but it did not bode well for my vacation. So yeah. I'm like, oh, good. I just got here and look at this. Mm-hmm. So by the time I got to the resort, I stayed at the All-Star Music Resort, which was, you know, mm-hmm. it was fine. It's one of the discount ones, but it's still, you know, it's
yeah,
not the worst place I've ever stayed. I've played in some stayed in some rat holes, you know, when I used to work the circuit. So this was, you know, a really nice room compared to yeah. that. But, you know, no coffee pot, no microwave. That was kind of lame. But, you know, what do you want? By the time I got there,
yeah, I'm trying to remember what we had, because we stayed at the French Quarter.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a much more expensive, yeah, and probably much nicer, I would hope, for the price. I almost stayed there, but I was like, meh.
It was moderately priced compared to some.
Yeah.
So.
But, by the time I walked to my room, I was so drenched from the rain, and there was giant puddles, and I was just like, okay. Mm-mm. And the news is like, well, there's a light rain in Orlando right now. I'm just like, wow, I respect your guys' idea of what a light rain is. Because this yeah. is, you know, I mean, we get some torrential storms in California. People laugh, but we do. And mm-hmm. this was, you know, not a torrential storm, but it was big raindrops. I mean, it was a wet rain, if that makes sense, yeah. you know. So at that point, I was like, you know what? Yeah, I think I'm staying in the room tonight. So I ended up going to Magic Kingdom on Friday.
Okay.
Because I was staying in a resort, you get that extra hour in the morning. Yes. You get to go and, you know, they take yeah. you right to either, I don't know what they take you to over in the Fantasyland, because it's only two areas that open up, Fantasyland and Future. Whatever, what do they call it? Future?
Tomorrowland.
Tomorrowland, thank you. I'm thinking, mm-hmm. I'm thinking like, you know, Westworld and Future World, all the movies. So they, I went to Tomorrowland and they take you directly to Space Mountain. And boy, did I regret getting on Space Mountain.
Why? The
Space Mountain in Florida is painful. I mean, it's the same ride as they have in California.
Yeah.
But when I got on there, it was incredibly bumpy and it hurt. I mean, it was really jerky. It felt like the car I was in just, you know, I don't know. It was nowhere near as nice of a ride as it was in California. I mean, it made me sore. Of course, I was just in a car wreck recently, so that might have yeah. played a role into it. But, you know, none of the other roller coasters had this effect. So, after riding that, I immediately went over to Buzz Lightyear's Space Ranger Spin, which is just, you know, kind of, it's a dark ride, but it's not very dark.
It's a video game.
Yeah. Like, and it was a blast.
Yes, it's so much fun. Grayson and I went on it at Disneyland and World, and it's like, you just fight each other trying to get the high score.
Mm-hmm. It was a lot of fun. It was just, you know, just even just looking at the different characters from Toy Story and all that was pretty fun. And to be honest, it was already really, really hot and humid,
mm-hmm.
and it wasn't even 9 o'clock yet. So I walked around. I did get on People Mover.
Yeah, we didn't go on that one.
Well, People Mover, we used to have People Mover in California, in Anaheim, mm-hmm. And I rode it back in, like, 1979, 1980, when I was 9 or 10 years old.
Yeah.
And the last, you know, obviously the last three times I've been to Disneyland, it didn't exist anymore. You know, the rails are there, but they don't do it anymore. So it was kind of nostalgic for me to actually get on People Mover there. And it's not really much of a ride. It's just kind of, you know, it's one of those rides where you just get on it so you can sit down for a little bit. They don't really show you that much. You do see some behind the scenes kind of things, but it's not mm-hmm. not terribly exciting. But it's nice to be able to just sit there and kind of relax for a minute. Mm-hmm. After that, you know, it was about 9 o'clock, you know, the majority of people hadn't gotten too far into the park yet that finally got let in. So I went over to, well, I was trying to get over to Big Thunder Mountain, so I went to Fantasyland. Mm-hmm. And, you know, there's, you gotta ride It's a Small World no matter what. It's just, there's no two ways about it. But I was going, I was like, oh, hey, they have, you know, I was on this whole kick. I wanted to ride all the dark rides. So I'm like, oh, hey, they got the Seven Dwarfs Mine Train.
Yes.
Oh, right on. I'll go on that. That'll be, in, you know, kind of cute. I'll see if it's any different than it is in Anaheim.
They don't have it in Anaheim.
I know that. Now. I got in line. I didn't realize it was a mine train. I thought it was the same dark ride that they had in California. No. It's a roller coaster, and it is an awesome roller coaster. Yes.
It's so much fun.
I got to ride it once the entire time I was there. Every other time, the wait was like 100 and 100 plus minutes. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, eh, well, you know, I tried to get a fast pass for it, but, you know, nah, didn't happen.
We rode it at night when we were there. Because that's when it was down. I think, like, one time after dinner, it was down to, like, an hour. And we were like, yeah, whatever.
Even that time, the wait was about 35 or 40 minutes. And I was like, okay, But I was like, worth it. After, I want to do this again.
Oh, my God, yes. We rode in the front the second time. The first time, we were, like, two or three rows back. And yes, it's so much fun. And we would sing along with the song. And so we're like the only one singing at the top of our lungs in the cave.
It is an awesome. That ride alone kind of makes me go, you know what? I could go back next year, but we'll see. I did obviously ride Big Thunder Mountain Railway.
Is that one different? It was closed when we went.
I don't think so. I mean, it starts inside instead of outside, which most of the rides at Disney World does because of the rain and the weather. It didn't seem like it was that different. To be honest, I only got to ride it once this last time I went to Disneyland. Mm-hmm. And after, you know, I stood in line for an hour, I made the mistake of going the first day of spring break, so it was my fault. But by the time I was done with that ride, I just like, okay, I've been here 10 hours and I've ridden three things. So, riding it, I got to ride it about 14 times. So, over the course of my vacation, so I was very happy with that.
Wow.
Yeah. I mean, there's, in the morning, you know, multiple times, the wait was listed as 10 minutes, and it was, there was no way it was 10 minutes. It was, like, maybe 5. It was longer to walk there than, you know, any of the
Yeah, I was going to say, like, it's because it's in the back of the park, and so...
Right.
People in the morning, it's like, okay, you get distracted by everything that's before.
Yeah, and I think there's a lot of people going to the Seven Dwarfs ride. I think that's the big thing right now.
That's true, yeah.
And they probably assume since, Splash Mountain? Splash Mountain being down, and I think there was one other ride that was down over there for maintenance that people were probably like, well, we don't need to go over there for just one ride. There's plenty of stuff over here kind of thing.
Yeah.
That was a blast. The first time I got the first ride of Big Mountain or Big Thunder Mountain that I did, you know, they put me in the front row. I'm like, oh, okay. So I'm going to add something here. The last time I went to Disneyland prior to this year, this was back in 2010, I believe. I went with a friend. I was working in a hospital. I was on call all the time. There's a lot of stress. We were moving hospitals and, you know, family members with cancer having, you know, going to ER all the time and my brother's suicide and all this stuff. There was a lot of anxiety. So I was at the point where It's a Small World was actually almost too much of a ride for me to handle at Disneyland. So that gives you an idea what level my anxiety and stress was at the time. So Big Thunder Mountain, when I got on there and it was in the front row, I'm like, I can't remember this ride at Disneyland. I can't remember anything about it. It's going to be fast. And like for a moment, I started having anxiety about anxiety. Not the roller coaster, just like, oh, am I going to freak out? Oh, no, I think I'm freaking out about freaking out.
Yeah.
Got on there. I'm like, oh, yeah. Turned around, got right back on, rode like, you know, four more times in a row right then. It was a blast. I'm trying to think of what else is at. Oh, yeah, Space Mountain I already talked about.
Yeah.
It's a small world. I mean, you have to do it.
Right.
I rode Peter Pan's flight twice. I got disoriented a little bit after, because I was in the park for 14 hours that first day. And it was hot and I was still jet lagged. So I actually, the first time I got on Peter Pan's flight, it's because it said it was 10 minutes. And I was just like, for some reason in my brain, it's like, oh, that's the Seven Dwarfs roller coaster. And then I go through the line, da-da-da, not paying attention, and, you know, it's like, oh, what is this? Okay, there's a line of people behind me now, so I guess I'm committed.
Yeah.
And then I went on a second time, the next time I was in Magic Kingdom, just simply because, like, they have air conditioning. I did go on Under the Sea, A Journey of the Little Mermaid.
That was cute.
They had air conditioning, and there was nobody there. Honest to God, it took me longer to walk the cavalcade than the ride was, or to get on the ride. It was just like, okay.
The ride broke down while we were on it, so.
Oh, I would have been jealous.
It was just funny because, like, the animatronics, like, they stop and they stop their usual voice and, like, have another, like, don't worry, everything's okay. Like, we'll be back running soon.
Well, they do the same thing in Haunted Mansion, but it's just a disembodied voice. Yeah. That would have been cool. I would have liked to have seen
that. Yeah, it was interesting to have Sebastian suddenly, like, warning us about the ride.
But it was funny because I walked in there and there's nobody there except, you know, the girls working at the, you know, the let you on the thing. And I'm just like, okay, I know this isn't for me, but there's air conditioning. And she kind of laughed and was like, yeah, it gets a little even too cold for me in there, so enjoy. I'm like, awesome.
So, yeah.
Haunted Mansion, I actually lost track of how many times I went on there. Only like maybe six times. One of the times during the not-so-scary Halloween. Oh, that's the other thing. On Friday, I bought the additional ticket to do the 7 to whenever Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween. I have to be honest, it was kind of wasted on me because, you know, if you want to go get candy, you know, there's candy and stuff, but I didn't see, like, the stage show didn't really do anything for me and I ended up going home during all that. But it was cool seeing all the actors in kind of the updated or, you know, like having cobwebs on their costumes and stuff. And it was cool because I don't know the character's name, but one of the ladies was sitting out there who, you know, I think she was singing, she was interacting with people, but it was really trippy because they did the black lights and everything on her and she looked like a freaking ghost.
Yeah.
It was really trippy. I mean, it's just, I have to take my hat off to Disneyland. They, you know, they have gotten this down to a science.
Oh, yes.
All
of it runs like it's a very well-oiled machine.
Yeah. Except when things break and then you're just kind of sitting there looking at a red-eyed raven haunted mansion. Okay. And it's just like, bark, bark, bark. Then Saturday, my birthday. The goal was to go to Animal Kingdom and ride. I had a fast pass for the whatever that ride is over in Pandora, whatever it's called.
Yeah.
I had a fast pass for.
How is all of that?
I didn't get on the ride.
Okay.
Yeah, things happen. So the first fast pass was for the water. I have it written down here somewhere. The basically their water ride, Cali River Rapids.
Oh. Okay.
And rode that, and it was fun. It was, you know, not terribly exciting, to be honest. But it was cool. It was nice and wet and felt good. But I was sore. When I got off Space Mountain, and I'm sure getting on, you know, Seven Dwarfs, that sounded dirty, getting on the Seven Dwarfs mine train and Big Thunder Mountain multiple times during the day didn't help things, but in my back, it started spasming, and I was just having a really hard time walking, and so I rode that. I ended up going back to the hotel and just kind of relaxing for a while. And since it was my birthday, I was like, you know what? I'm just going to take it easy, try to get another fast pass for that stuff later.
Yeah.
I ended up going to Disney Springs.
Mm.
And Disney Springs is just basically an outdoor mall and restaurant and an AMC. Did you go to the AMC when you were there?
No, we went to the arcade.
Oh, the AMC serves food and booze during the movies.
Oh.
Like, you hit a button, they bring you a menu, and the food was good. But that was a different day. I went and saw it. I'll talk about that in a minute. But I went over to, what was it, STK, and had this lobster and grits, which on paper just sounds like lobster and grits. The grits were incredible. It could have been a dish unto itself. And the lobster, I mean, it's lobster. It's going to be good. And I had mussels. I had just all this stuff. And this was my birthday. So I was like, I'm having seafood. And it was awesome. The next day, was it? Yeah, Sunday, I went to Epcot. And went through every country. They're doing
Epcot.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. I did Spaceship Earth, which I was a little bit... I didn't know what to expect with that. You know,
which one is that?
That's the big...
Inside the ball?
Inside the ball, yeah.
Okay.
That's the one that goes through, like, history, and it's like...
Yeah.
Oh, if you like the alphabet, you know, think the Venetians, and it's like, oh, okay, this is kind of... Okay. After spending the entire, you know, entire day at Magic Kingdom going to Epcot for anything other than food was like, okay. I did go, what's the name of it? The Club Cool? Cool Club? Club Cool. The Coca-Cola place where you can go and get all the free samples you want.
Yeah.
I tried to do the Beverly Challenge. Have you had Beverly?
No.
Yeah, I've watched some YouTubers like Justin Scard, Adam Lewu, Tim Tracker, and some others, and they'll go and they'll do this thing called the Beverly Challenge, and I can't remember where this soda is made and is popular, but everybody's like, it's super hard to drink, it's nasty, it's just gross, and you know, they always make a big deal about it. And I'm sitting there thinking, there's no way this can be that bad. It probably tastes like diet soda or, you know, flat diet soda or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And the little cups are, I don't know, a couple ounces. And I got a thing of this and I failed miserably. That stuff is nasty. I'm just like, no. And then I went and had like three different kinds of Fanta that tasted amazing that you can't get in the States, but.
Yeah.
I did go through all the different countries. That was a day, you know, like I was like, okay, I'm going to go through and sample all this different stuff. Because they do have actual people from different countries representing their country and, you know.
Yes. It's an intern program.
Yeah.
So we were at, I guess it was Norway.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we were talking to a couple of the kids that were there. And they were like, yeah, we get to come here for a year. And, like, you know, Disney pays for everything. Like, they get, you know, schooling and experience and, you know, English and all that kind of stuff. And then they get to go back. So
that's cool. Yeah, I went to France because I was like, you know what? I'm going to try escargot.
Mm-hmm.
And the way they were presenting it was in a croissant, and it was like a lot of garlic butter.
Mm-hmm.
And the garlic butter was overpowering. And it wasn't bad. It's just like, eh, okay, well, I've done that. I don't need to ever do it again. But there was a lot of really good food there.
Yes.
And it's all sample size. It's not like full meals. I mean, you can get full meals, but the stuff that they're doing for this is just like, oh, you know, here's a little sausage with a little scoop of potato or something. It's like, oh, that's cool. So you can eat stuff, walk around. By the time you've walked from one country, one pavilion, whatever, to the next, you've already burned those calories because there's like, you know, nothing to it. And it was like, oh, okay, cool. One thing I need to add to the Magic Kingdom trip.
Mm-hmm.
They had Dole Whips.
Yes.
Oh, I've never had a Dole Whip before.
Ah.
I've heard all these people talk about Dole Whips.
Mm-hmm.
And then I heard somebody say, oh, they don't have Dole Whips at Magic Kingdom or Walt Disney World. They're just a California thing. I'm like, oh, okay. Boy, was I surprised when I went over to Adventureland over by the Aladdin stuff. And they're like, Dole Whips. Okay, thank you.
We went to the Dole Plantation in Hawaii.
Oh, really?
So that was where I had Dole Whip.
Right on. It was good.
It was really good.
As far as Epcot goes, oh, I can't remember. They did a cartoon shorts in 3D, and it was one was really good. It was I can't think of the character. I think it was Mickey and them. I'm trying to remember now. There was so much that happened. And it was 3D, and, like, they came out of the stage, and, like, part of the stage blew up, and there was, you know, wind, and, you know, the seats had little, you know, fans and things in there. So, and then it went into other 3D cartoons that were not so good. The Disney one just blew everything away, so, mm-hmm. obviously. But that was a lot of fun. I'm really trying to... obviously, Test Track. Test Track and... what was the spaceship one? The reopened... Mission to Space.
Is that the one where you're in the little pod thing with everyone?
Yeah, and it's very like claustrophobic. Gary Sinise? I don't think Gary Sinise was in it. He might have been a voice.
Maybe I'm thinking of something else. Is that the one where they tell you the mission stuff and everyone has a role?
Yes. And there's
at the beginning of it. He's the like human that you talk to.
Okay, because there's two different versions. There's the easy, there's the easy one that's very claustrophobic, and then there's the mission to Mars, which they kind of warn you about that is really super intense and really claustrophobic, and you know it's very
I think that's the one we did.
That's the one I did too, and it's just like. I'm like, wow. I mean,
because you're right up against that screen.
Yeah, and
you're like, you focus on this and do not deviate from the screen.
Yeah, because you feel it, and it's just like, wow, that was pretty intense. I can't remember. Is Soarin' over in Epcot? I think it is.
Yes.
Yeah. So I made the mistake of riding Soarin' again, and I knew better.
Because
for some reason they always put the fat guy in the fourth row, which is the highest row that goes up. I'm not very good with heights.
why do you keep doing this stuff?
I don't know. And it's funny because it was far more terrifying than any roller coaster, but it's gorgeous. I mean, how can you not ride it? I mean, you know, I did sit there and white knuckle through the entire thing just because, you know, they start tilting you forward and you feel like you're going to fall. But I know you're completely safe, but it's like IMAX. It's just all encompassing your view and it's just crystal clear and it's amazing, but terrifying. I did Test Track. Did you do Test Track when you were there? That one was pretty cool. It was kind of, that one kind of hurt a little bit.
Twice, I think.
Really?
Yeah.
I had a fast pass to do it a second time, but the ride was closed. And they're like, well, you know, you can come back. We'll honor it later tonight. And I'm like, I'm going to go here instead. I went back to Magic Kingdom or something later that night. But
yeah, we all of our passes were only one day per park. So we couldn't do any of the hopping.
Yeah. Ooh, I'm sorry.
No, I mean, it was fine. We spent, like, we were there from opening to close for each of the parks.
I tried to do that, but, like, Epcot and Hollywood are really just kind of, like, quarter, half-day kind of size. They don't really have as much, unless you really want to go and look at all the little details. And I kind of went for rides.
We stayed at Epcot. I mean, we watched the fireworks show.
I missed all the fireworks.
Hollywood.
I missed all the fireworks.
Yeah, we watched fireworks every night.
I was going there so early. By the time it was started getting dark, I was too sore. I was too tired. I kind of wish I hadn't gone this early after the accident, but it had already been planned. Because I was definitely feeling some of the, you know, back spasms and the kind of the pain that, because of the car wreck I was in, kind of popped up. Oh, I did, where was this at? Muppet Vision 3D, where was that one at? Is that it? No, that's not Epcot, is it? No. Anyway, Epcot, food, those things. Hollywood Studios. Okay, remember how I mentioned that I got put on the first, you know, front row of Big Thunder Mountain?
Yeah.
Same thing happened there. I used the Fast Pass. I did not research Rock and Roller Coaster featuring or starring Aerosmith.
Mm-hmm.
I knew it was a fast roller coaster. I did not know that it was an indoor loop-de-loop, multiple corkscrew roller coaster, because I generally don't go on those.
So yeah, it was closed when we went.
Oh, it was the first time I went. I did go twice because I'm a glutton for punishment. They put me in the front row, and this other lady came in there. And she's like, "Oh, your first time riding on here? Yeah, actually, it is. Could you tell?" Because I'm just like holding on to the thing because I have no idea what to expect. And they're like, "Yeah, make sure that you put your head all the way back, and that you know when they launch, because you know if you don't, you're gonna whiplash." And I'm like, "Oh, okay." And then that thing took off, and it's kind of a dark ride roller coaster with loop-de-loops and corkscrews, but there's all this kind of black light, you know, because it's supposed to take place down in L.A., so, you know, you're passing 101 signs and 405, and it's just kind of, it's a fun roller coaster. I would take it over Space Mountain any day of the week, and I don't care for loop-de-loop, so that's saying a lot. Let's see, some of these are, I don't know if they're going to be in the same place. I did not go on Tower of Terror because I am a wuss and I just do not like drop scares. Someday I'll probably get on there, but, you know, I really, really doubt it.
I don't either, but it was okay. Like, I don't know. I can't explain it right. Like, it mostly because you just feel like the wind rushing up. Mm-hmm. Like, it's not like a drop like roller coaster drop. But that one's interesting, mostly because saying that one's the only one that's still Twilight Zone. Like the one in Disneyland is
Guardians
now Marvel. So
and I'm curious to find out from people who have ridden it if they think it's, as far as the actual ride portion, not the theming, just the ride portion, if it's improved, if they did anything to make it better, different. Be curious. Let's see, what else did I ride over there? Oh, some of the non-rides. I did go and do Muppet Vision 3D, which was kind of cool. Country Bear Jamboree, because I had to. That's just something from my childhood. I had to do it. What else did I do that was just kind of... I was going to do the O Canada in the round, but I ended up getting up and going and doing something else at Epcot. I can't remember what it was. Oh, they have the... Oh, I feel crappy that I can't remember this. Because they don't have Hall of Presidents open right now, and they probably won't for the next, you know, 3 years. Mm-hmm. I think they're trying to bypass something or someone. They do this performance, and I can't think of what it was called, but it's all these men and women in period costume singing, and then you go into this room, and I'm trying... It's very much like the Abraham Lincoln... thing in California. I can't think of who it was that was in there. It was Mark Twain and... Oh, hell. I'm sorry, I can't remember. But anyway, that was a lot of fun. Then, on either Monday or Tuesday, I went back to Disney Springs after going to Epcot again, and I went and saw It at the AMC Theater.
Mm-hmm.
And that was very cool. The movie was awesome. Have you seen it?
No.
Oh.
It's okay.
Any doubt that I had about that movie, because we discussed it based on trailer before.
Right,
If they only do a second movie, you know, part two, chapter two, with the adults and their thing, I'm all on board, because the first one was awesome, and, you know, but I thought somebody was saying it was going to be a trilogy, and that it shouldn't be. But if it is, you know, part one, part two, and that's it, it was good. I enjoyed it. Anyway, the theater was awesome. They had a drink there called, it was inspired by the movie It. I have no idea what it was. I'm not sure how much it was. All I know is at the end of the night, I think my bill was $80 for the food and the drinks and everything. So it was a blast, though. That was a lot of fun. I'm trying to think of if there's anything I'm missing. I was on my feet so much and walking around. Oh, Animal Kingdom. Oh, well, let's go back to Hollywood Studios really quick. I did see the First Order March, and I saw their starting of their performance, and I was like, okay, cool. I am going to go this way, because it was just so packed. And while everybody was there, that's when I went and got on Rock and Roller Coaster. That's when my Fast Pass was, so I ended up having to go over there. But I did film them marching towards the entrance and everything.
Mm-hmm.
It was pretty cool.
It is. It's like, cool that you, and then they have like the little show with Vader and Boba Fett and everybody.
I saw them walk over to it, because I went and did the Star Tours.
Yeah. Star Tours did you see? Are they still doing the one with, do they have a Rogue One one?
I don't think so.
Okay.
If they did, I didn't get to see it. I saw the, it was where 3PO accidentally becomes the pilot of the ship, and
that's all of them.
Yeah. Yeah.
But where did you guys go? Where did you go? Because there's like three or four first scenes, and then three or four second scenes.
I don't remember.
Okay.
Honestly, that was one of the few things that were. Yeah, I went on it, and I don't honestly recall. Wow, I am drawing a complete blank.
Okay.
That kind of sucks, because, I mean, I was excited to go get on there, but I don't remember anything about it other than 3PO was the pilot and whiny as ever. I don't recall. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
I did go to Monsters, Inc. Laugh Floor, which was actually a lot of fun. It was actually pretty funny. Obviously, I did Small World. I actually rode that, like, twice. I had to. The first time I didn't have my camera out to where I could take a photo. I saw Don Quixote on his broomstick horse, and I was like, I want a picture of that. So I had to go on there again to get a picture of Don Quixote, because that book was good. What else? Walt Disney Railroad, of course. You have to do that at least once. I watched the Muppets, whatever in history, Great Day in History, part of it. And I was like, okay, I'm done. rode the riverboat. So that was that. It was a blast. I want to go back, but at the same time, I'm like, well, if I never make it back, that's fine too. Yeah. I'm going to try to go to Disneyland one more time this year. Pick a week where it's slow and go on a Monday, Tuesday, and see, you know, go to work on the weekend to make up for it or something, go down there. But we'll see. What have you been up to?
Not that much. Went to see the new Blade Runner, 2049.
Thumbs up or thumbs down?
Oh, thumbs up.
Right on.
Like through the ceiling. and that's kind of about it. Next weekend, we're going to be in Portland for their retro game show. Video games. And then that's, and then the monster, what is that thing? Monsters.
The famous monsters.
Convention that's going on.
Right on.
End of the month, but.
Yeah. Which day are you going?
Saturday.
Okay. I bought a 3-day pass for that. Because I'm going to swing out there. I might swing out there Friday night just for shits and giggles. I'll be out there Saturday as well, but I'm also going to Winchester Mystery House that night. Okay. I'm doing the candlelight tour at 11:20, so.
Ooh.
Yeah, I know. I wanted to make sure that I was in the house at like 12 o'clock midnight. hopefully the tour lasts at least, 40 minutes. I doubt it, but you never know.
Yeah.
I also have some friends that are working there, so.
Okay.
Someone who will be in full costume, ghostly costume, it looks like, and so I'm just like, okay, cool. And I was like, hey, make sure you let me know where you're at when you're there. She's like, yeah, I will definitely let you know. So, any other plans as far as for Halloween or for October?
Not too many. For Halloween, we always give out candy. At our place, so we'll dress up. I still have to decorate for that, but that's not too much going on, kind of getting toward the relaxing time of the year.
Yeah, definitely. I'm actually kind of cheating because I'm going to try to participate as much as I can in NaNoWriMo.
Oh yes.
So I'm getting all my ducks in a row, all the information that I need before I start on the first. So I'm kind of hoping. Go ahead.
Yeah, if you sign up for the website or whatever, let me know, because I think we can be on a team.
Okay.
But I don't know. So I tried that back in, I guess, July, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
They had one earlier. And I was like, okay, I'm going to give this a try. And it was totally, it was weird. But
yeah.
It was camp nano writing. Mm-hmm. I think you're supposed to, interact a lot more than I do for it. Because I was just like, okay, I'll just track, how much I'm writing. And then I didn't end up writing very much and was sad. But, yeah.
Was it last year that I was going to participate? And I just failed miserably. I was like, oh, hey, it's now the 20th of November, and I don't even know what I haven't even sat down in front of it. Yeah. So,
well, the past, 3 years,
mm-hmm.
I had trips in November. And so trips plus Thanksgiving and stuff, usually, you know, you run out of time to sit and write. And so this year, I don't think we have anything going on. So hopefully I can actually knock out a chunk.
Yeah. And this, I think things might be actually winding up and not down where I'm at. So I got back from Walt Disney World. I got back to California on Wednesday of that, you know, the following week. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I had Thursday, Friday off, and I actually, I made the mistake of eating, I went out and had seafood again, and I had mussels that I brought home, and apparently you're not supposed to eat mussels if they haven't opened up when they were cooked. And nobody bothered to tell me this because I just like, oh, okay, well, I'm just, they're cooked, so they should be okay, right? And so for 2 days, I was pretty sick. I get back to work and, oh, the phone system is down. We have 16 people who don't have phones. And then it went from that to, oh, there's also this other set of 16 people who are on a different card that are hard down. They're not getting anything. And it's been a 2.5 week battle with this phone system to the point where it was made my priority over any other IT stuff. So that's been a nightmare. So I have a feeling come November, there's going to be some changes coming. And, you know, we're amping up for some other things as well. So, but I'm hoping that it will be mellow enough towards the end of the year that, you know, there won't be too many things preventing me from writing. You know, I can always take, you know, a laptop to work and write on my lunch break or whatever. So,
yeah.
All right. So, question for you.
Mm-hmm.
What is your favorite Halloween movie, since it is, you know, coming up here soon? You know, best Halloween movie to watch on Halloween or during October? Ooh, excuse me. I apologize for that. Sorry, I just, excuse me, I'm a pig.
Oh, that's a good question, because I don't like scary movies.
Mm-hmm. Well, now, you watched, what was the one, the Del Toro movie?
Crimson,
yeah.
That wasn't scary, though.
But it's a ghost story.
But they're good ghosts.
Yeah, but still, it's supernatural.
All right, fine. Then Crimson Peak.
Well, it could be anything else. It's Halloween night. You're there, you know. You have to choose a movie to watch. What movie would you watch? After, you know, hundreds of kids in costume and you're in costume and, you know, now it's time to settle down and watch a movie. What do you watch?
Jeez.
And again, it doesn't have to be a horror movie at all.
I know. But it should be, because it's Halloween.
Yeah.
Like, that's what I'm trying to think of, like, a horror movie that I'm okay watching. one might exist. Or maybe Resident Evil?
Okay.
That's sort of, there's zombies and stuff.
Yeah.
Absolutely
within the realm of horror and
spooky
and undead. I mean, come on, that's, there you go.
What about you?
I mean, obviously the first two Halloween movies, if they're on television, I'll definitely watch them. I don't really go out and try to watch horror anymore, which is weird considering I'm trying to do a horror podcast. I think for this year, I've been putting it off just because I figure, okay, I'll watch it, you know, on the weekend of Halloween or, you know, like Sunday after Winchester Mystery House. The Witch, which I've heard incredible things of, and I've seen some scenes from it, and it's definitely not...
Is that the one that came out recently?
Yes. And it's... All the dialogue, as I understand it, is from actual transcripts. Not necessarily the same people, but they took dialogue from actual these things happening and these things happening, and they put it all together as this family's life and everything. And it looks very cool. I did see a couple scenes of it. I was just like looking for something. I was like, what would be weird? And, you know, I found, I think something on YouTube where they just kind of had a scene on there. I'm like, oh, this is the end scene. Oh, you jerks. But anyway, it still looked awesome. So I'm,
yeah, let me know what you think. Okay. Grayson saw that. So,
okay. Did he like it?
No.
No, really? Because it's definitely not a fast film. I watched, like, the first 10 minutes or so of it.
Yeah, he said that there was no part that was scary.
Yeah. And I
That it was more of a, like, period piece.
Oh, yeah, it's definitely a period. Like I said, all the dialogue is actually dialogue from that time period that people, you know, that were recorded.
Right, yeah.
But, you know, not of all the same people. They just, you know, cherry picked what they wanted for dialogue, but I will probably watch Halloween just for giggles. Either that or Texas Chainsaw Massacre 2, which I recently acquired, which I have not seen since I saw it in the theater with my mom when it came out. I just got a lot of feedback. Hold on.
Yeah, it just sort of popped on. Fine.
Okay. Can you hear me okay?
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know what that was about. Okay. You were going to say something? I'm sorry. I didn't mean to cut you off.
Oh, no. I don't remember what it was. So keep going.
Okay. So normally we discuss movie trailers. The good part about them, the bad part about them, the ugly part about them, whether or not we'd see them. I have a feeling that you and I probably want to talk about the same exact trailer.
Mm-hmm.
So let's just go ahead and talk about it. That It trailer was incredible. Oh, no. So they released the trailer for Star Wars Episode 8.
Yep.
So there are many parts of that trailer that make me feel giddy. There's one that actually I would put under ugly, though. But, so what was your impression of the trailer?
I thought it was good. I liked a lot of it. I mean, as we've discussed, like, we're going to go see it regardless of what they put out. I mean, they could put nothing out and it wouldn't matter. we would still be going and seeing it. Yeah, I mean, overall it looked good. I've only seen it, I think I watched it a couple of times when it came out.
I actually downloaded it from YouTube and I went frame by frame. I have no complaints about the visuals of it. The one thing I didn't like was there is a scene where Kylo Ren is apparently in his, what is it, TIE silencer? Is that what they call it?
TIE interceptor.
Well, I thought his was called a silencer or something. His new one. I'm not sure. But anyway, he's flying allegedly in the ship that Princess Leia is in, his mom. And there's this whole scene where, you know, they make it appear like...
Yeah, that he's thinking about blowing her up.
Yeah, and that they know that they're there. And I'm just... I have a feeling that there's several scenes, like especially the scene between Kylo and Rey at the end. I don't think those scenes are in the same part of the movie. Because if and it's just the way they edit it, it's just... it's just like, okay. I mean, it's like they're trying to make a separate movie from the trailer, and I don't... That kind of bugged me.
I mean, I think that Leia will die in this movie.
Yeah, I do too.
And I think that will either, like, push him into the dark side or pull him out.
Yeah.
And so it's possible that that scene is, like, you know, after it happens or, like, when someone else does it or maybe he's thinking about doing it and someone else actually pulls the trigger.
Yeah.
But, no, I don't think that he will do it.
I posted this on Twitter. I hope Rey goes full-blown dark side. in this movie.
That's not going to happen.
It could. I mean, no. Just think about it. I mean, can you imagine how amazing that would be? I mean, this ultra powerful being, just pure going, pure evil. I mean, that's about the only way I can see, you know, Kylo, you know, getting redeemed, is like bringing her back somehow from the dark side. And I don't know how he would do that either, but I don't know. I just, there's all these like ideas like, oh man, if she goes dark side, that would be so awesome because they can never stop her. And, you know, just, it makes me giddy thinking about her just going full blown Sith, you know. I don't know why, but I think I would adore her, absolutely adore her as a full-fledged Sith.
Yeah.
I don't think it would happen, but, oh, I would love it to happen.
Yes, that's not going to happen.
You never know. You never know. Luke was a little weird in this.
Well, I think he's a little weird now.
Yeah.
Period. I mean, they made the comment before that, like, it's not always good meeting your heroes.
Yeah.
And, yeah, he's been a hermit for however long. And...
yeah. And it's weird the things that Mark Hamill was saying, like, he didn't necessarily like the direction that they went in with Luke. And seeing the way he was in the trailer, I'm like, oh, but I think I see what the director is going for, because he's definitely kind of... he might just be just completely scarred emotionally, you know?
Yeah.
So, that is very cool. So, we're both in agreement. We're both going to go see this regardless.
Mm-hmm.
There are some beautiful scenes in there when Kylo's looking out the window and you see all those new AT, whatever they are.
Yeah.
Or 487, whatever it is.
Yeah.
Those, I didn't realize that people were being serious when they said that they look like gorillas now.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, oh, yeah, they do. That's mm-hmm. kind of odd. I don't know that I like those that much. I mean, I've liked all the other vehicles that they've added, but those, I don't know.
Yeah. How do you feel about the porgs?
It can go one of three ways. They could be just cute little pet things that just happen to be there that aren't really a main focus, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Or they can go the way of Jar Jar, where they're just absolutely... they make you want to murder the director and the writer and everybody involved. Or they can be like Ewoks, where it's like, okay, you know, we'll be making Ewok barbecue remarks, but, you know, they weren't quite as offensive as, you know, Jar Jar Binks.
I'm concerned. Like, I mean, they are cute, but I don't want a movie of them.
Yeah, and I'm really, truly hoping that the one that's in that scene just accidentally was in the cockpit and, you know, is removed afterwards and that there's no focus on it whatsoever.
I don't know, because there's a lot of porg merchandise.
Yeah, and that concerns me, but I don't know. Here's the thing. If they make Rey go completely Sith, I'll forgive anything. I'll forgive Jar Jar Binks if they make Rey go Sith and just make her this complete badass Sith and just take out everyone. The Emperor, the new Emperor guy, you know, Kylo, Luke. Hell, maybe she'll blow up Leia and, you know, yeah, it'll just be amazing.
Yeah.
I want a photo of her face just with that, just pissed off, and just like have the, you know, the, what's it, you know, the yellow eyes and just be all Sithed out and just like,
I'm sure it exists.
Probably. I'm sure somebody has edited the photo. I think, matter of fact, I probably have seen it already. So, yeah, I think that movie's going to be a lot of fun regardless. Yeah, those,
Yeah, there are a lot of images of her as a Sith, so yeah. you can look online.
Yeah, but I want like the full cardboard, you know, life. No, I'm kidding now. But I would like to see her like just go completely badass. Like I don't want like no restraint kind of, you know. But
they're not gonna Disney. Do that. In the, I mean, yeah, it's a Disney and it's for kids. Like they're not gonna do that.
Yeah, which is unfortunate, but it would be cool. It would be awesome. They should do an unrated version for adults. And just have Rey kill everyone. Just rah! Hey, they did.
I'm sure there's a porn of it. So.
I know nothing about any Star Wars parodies in that realm at all. Even though I think I know somebody who made one of the costumes for one. I may have met a cosplayer that supplied some of the costume for one of those kind of movies. But we won't go there. Oh, good Lord. What was I going to say? There was something that just crossed my mind. Yeah, I've been trying to ignore the bird things. I'm not even going to try to call them by whatever name they gave them. Because I'm hoping they don't exist. You know, if it's just a pet, if it's just in the background, if it's intelligent and it's fighting and it's talking, you know, if it's just like a bird thing that just happens to be around and, you know, it tends to be a delicacy on most planets and, you know, I'm not going to be that offended. But if it's there just through the entire movie and they try to make that the focus, oh no. Oh well. So. Here's another question for us, and then we will call it an evening. So after, I was kind of thinking about this because I was going into a place that could have been totally devastated by a hurricane. So the question for this week, there's a storm coming, and it could devastate the entire state, blah, 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 hurricane, whatever. You find shelter, but you're alone. There's no cell phone activity, you can't get on the internet, you have plenty of food to be down there for, you know, a day or a year or however long that you have to be there until this blows over and you can actually get out again. If you go outside, you're dead. You're stuck here. You're stuck. It's the typical storyline that we have for most of these questions.
Yeah.
What one item would you want to have with you? And now keep, again, you know, it can be a cell phone, but you're not going to be able to call anybody. You're not going to be able to text. There's no communication whatsoever. This is just for you in wherever you are in shelter. What would you want?
So I would take a notebook. 'Cause since I'll be there and I can't get on the internet, then I can write till my heart's content. And
well, you can have a laptop. It's just you wouldn't have internet connectivity, so you can write on that too. I just want to say that there's no way to communicate with the outside world. Whatever you take in there, you can have plenty of power and battery and everything else, but you just can't communicate. You are blocked off.
Okay. So yeah, either a notebook or my laptop to write would be what I would take, because that would keep my time.
Yeah.
And without the distractions of the internet, I could probably finish all of my book ideas.
See, my spelling's so bad. I need the internet just to learn how to spell things. What's the word for this? What's juxtaposition? Juxtaposition? Help me,
well,
internet,
I mean,
help me.
You have to transcribe it anyway. So.
Yeah, this is true. I was thinking a video recorder.
Okay.
For two reasons. Number one, eventually I would get out there, and who knows, they could be a vlog. If not, then I would actually be sitting there documenting my complete and utter mental breakdown. And, you know, when whoever found my carcass, they would know what my last days were. It sounds a little bit morbid, but, you know.
Yeah.
It, yeah. I think it would be a video camera, just simply because, you know, I'd have plenty of time. Like, I could come up with ideas and just talk. Like, I do that now with audio recorders. I'll have them in the car with me, and I'll just, like, oh, idea, record. So, with a video, at least then I could, like, you know, actually have visual references once I get out of there of what things were like. So, I don't know. It seems kind of vain, truthfully. A laptop would probably be a much better idea, but... or a game console of some sort.
Yeah.
My entire video collection, no. Was one item, so... Yeah, I think I'd go with a video recorder.
Yeah.
Just, I don't know. It's just, for some reason, I'd want to document it. So.
And you could.
Yeah. Alrighty. Well, I think that's it for this time. I will be posting this weekend. It is currently, I already mentioned this, 10/11/2017. So this will go live on, what is the date? Actually, it might go live Saturday the 14th. Ooh, Friday is the 13th.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't realize that.
You can watch Friday the 13th on Friday the 13th.
I could. I watched those so much when I was a kid that, like, I don't... like, literally, I saw 3, 4, 5. I didn't see 6 in the theater or any of the ones. I saw a couple of them after that, though, in the theater. But, you know, the whole you have to be 18 to see certain movies, or you have to be, you know, PG-13 or R-rated. They were a little lax with that in the 80s.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I remember going in and seeing Friday the 13th movies at, you know, age 14, 15. Mom would just drop me off in front of the theater, and I'd walk in and buy my ticket. So, yeah. All right, so this will be posted in the next couple days. I'm trying to think. There was one other thing. On a personal note, I've been uploading and making live all my previous vlogs. They are on youtube.com/EakinJ, E-A-K-I-N-J. They're horrible. I haven't really been spending much time worrying about what I've been recording and editing. It's been mostly to get past the idea of putting myself out there. So I am going to start actually working towards doing real vlogs. And I'm going to start with some locations in Livermore. I went to City Hall today. I had to take care of some other business. And when I was there, I picked up a couple bicentennial. And was it bicentennial? 100 years for 1980-something going back to whatever. And then one from a couple years ago, which was like, it was 2012, back 100 years, whatever. So, there's definitely some weird stuff in this town that I'm going to try to do vlogs on, but I have to do it kind of covertly so I don't get chased off by somebody with a shotgun or, you know, a crucifix or something. Like, there's a steeple. There's a steeple in town, which I use on my video, part of the intro, that's just sitting in this lot. It's just, you know, it's on, you know, these, like, four, not 4x4s, but like 8x8 poles that's just holding it up in the air. And it's literally just a steeple. There's no church attached to it.
Oh, weird.
It's just, you know, just a bell tower. And it used to be part of a Presbyterian church that burned down. And that was the only portion they saved. But they didn't bother to attach it to another building. They just put it up there and left it there. So stuff like that would be pretty cool to just go and, you know, do quick little vlogs on and kind of get comfortable doing that, since I do have to deal with the public when I'm doing the docent interpreter thing up at Columbia. So
yeah,
it all kind of feeds into that. And plus it's history and, you know, so any other plans coming up?
No, just enjoying town, not relaxing.
Right on.
Playing games, watching movies.
Oh, by the way, I'm watching Game of Thrones, but I'm watching it backwards. I'm doing the same thing I did with Doctor Who. So I've watched 7, 6, 5. I'm on season 4 now. Now, I'm not watching the episodes backwards, just the seasons.
Okay.
So it makes sense, but I'm like watching, you know, Jon Snow, you know, what happens in season 6 to Jon Snow, and then going back and seeing what led up to what happened in the end of season 5, and, you know, so it's been a lot of fun, so.
Okay. Yeah, we can discuss those.
Okay, cool. Well, you know, when season 8 can come out, they're going to be filming that all next year, so I don't think it's going to be a while, so. Yeah, maybe we can pick a season that you enjoy a lot, and we'll go rewatch them, and we'll go over some of the episodes. Do you have a favorite episode? From any season?
I mean, they all blend together at this point.
Yeah, that's for sure.
But yeah, we can look at it. And
cool, excellent. Alrighty, everyone. Thank you guys for tuning in. And until next time.
Bye.
Night.